Yeah, let's say we are practical people. We work in the field, and we started about 3 years ago this new initiative called Circuit. Circuit is a circular community center where textiles is, sorry, I have to, where textiles is one important factor, as we will see during the presentation. This is a picture of Circuit when you come, for those who know Antwerp a little bit, so we have the Schelde, and when you come from the Schelde into this new area, you meet this big stair when you walk under a building. I will show some more pictures afterwards. And you get a circular community center on two floors in a very uptown neighborhood. The concept behind Circuit is that we wanted to create a circular playground for conscious consumption. So actually, the thing with Circuit is we don't want to be too explicit about that. It would be good to consume in a more conscious way. But everything we offer in Circuit is about conscious consumption. And everything we organize is also thought in this way. The whole building is thought in this way. The neighborhood of Circuit is thought in this way. So it's a lot of layers that all go towards sustainability. And the starting point behind this initiative is the Kringwinkel Antwerp, of which I will say a little bit more in the next slide. But together with 18, and I already heard it in other presentations, other 18 sustainable entrepreneurs. So the idea behind this is it's not anymore about Kringwinkel Antwerp doing things themselves. You should work together to make it happen. And it's all about buying local, consume local. It's about repair and DIY. And Kringwinkel has a long history in repair, but here we bring it up front. We also bring new business, like rental business models. And there's a lot of sustainable site activities to make all of this even more interesting, like workshops and reading. Some data about Kringwinkel Antwerp, who is, although the main actor behind this idea, it's because Kringwinkel Antwerp has some financial power that we could make this happen. So Kringwinkel Antwerp, each year we are now on about 9,000 tons of goods that we pick up. And this is about, let's say, 10% of this is textiles. But of course, we pick up a lot more than this. And we try to create a use out of this. And each ton of reuse that we create stands for about one ton of CO2 output that we avoid as a society. How do we do this? And that's the other side of the story, and that's where it links up very nicely also with the SDGs. We do this by creating jobs for people who have a distance to the labor market. So in the last year, we had about 590 jobs that we offered in this way. And 168 people that having the possibility to work with Kringwinkel found also a new job in the normal economy. This means that when you translate it to SDGs, we work on try to work on poverty, quality of education, as we offer some educational trajects, decent work for everybody. We are, of course, in the field of innovation because we try to link up all the social employment with creating reuse. It's also about a sustainable city, because of course we don't do this alone, but it's together with the habitants of the city of Antwerp that we do all of this, and with other entrepreneurs. It's about responsible consumption and climate action. Let's go back to Circuit then. So where is Circuit located? And for us, this was really important. Let's say it's kind of a rebranding of the usual kringwinkels that we know. Circuit is located uptown. So when you have Antwerp and you see this red spot on this map, you have the south of Antwerp, close to the Schelde. And what's important to know, we are inside what we call the Singel. So it's the most expensive area of Antwerp, and the south is in this area even more expensive. But normally these kind of social initiatives always appear in downtown. And it was a really conscious choice to bring this uptown, and also to give an appearance to this whole center that is really high end. And even if in the interior, in the materials we used are most of the time reuse or circular materials, at no time it feels like a second hand. It brings it to another level, a high end level. So Antwerp constructed a whole new area because we were missing a space to live, and in the middle of this area is a whole new building of Stefano Boeri. And Stefano Boeri is one of the biggest architects in the world, known for his Bosco Verticale buildings that look like bushes. And so the building in the center of this new uptown area is that's where Circuit is located. And it's a nice building, as we can see here. So very green. And it's already a touristical hotspot only because of this, how the building is made. Something else that's important, it's the most sustainable area of Antwerp. So what we see here in the picture, and I'm sorry, the picture is not so clear, but is the central heating station. So this whole area is warmed up by one heating station. For the moment, it turns on gas, but next to this living area comes also a sustainable industry area. And soon this heating station will turn with the rest heat of the industrial area next door. And which means, so not only the community center is about sustainability, but so the whole environment in which it's situated is sustainable. Circuit in practice, I told about 18 other entrepreneurs, and it's larger than, of course, textiles. There is the kringwinkel, and here the picture is about household wear, but I could have taken a picture from textiles as well, because there's also textiles. But then we have a coffee bar there, together with Oxfam, who rebranded itself also, so people can just come and drink a coffee, but a sustainable coffee. We have a flower guy, but that brings flowers that are local, not brought with a plane to Belgium with all this kind of pesticides. It's 100% bio-based. We have, you can go to the hairdresser there with natural products. Then here we see Kunig. Kunig is another social company that has where you can go to do some clothing repair. So you can buy like something in the kringwinkel that's too big or too small, and then immediately make it bigger or smaller so it fits better. You can also just walk in with something you have at home and that's not good anymore, where you want the reparation. And what they also do is making old furniture new, regarnishment. There's bike repair and the thing with all of these services is also you can always ask that they do it for you, but you can also take the option, I do it myself, and then they explain it to you on how you can do it. There's electronics repair. Then we also have this young entrepreneur called Warenhuis. She makes locally produced clothing for rain clothing for the bicycle. Really nice product, high quality, well thought about, and with a production cycle that's completely transparent. There's a bakery also on the site. There's an artist who uses wrist textiles to make artwork. There's a warehouse with packaging-free products that will come by April. And then we also have this big wall where young entrepreneurs who maybe don't have the money yet to take a whole unit, that they can, for a low price, show their products. And there you also see like Lapland, that's a lady that's out of wrist issues, makes new products. We also have Wereld Missiehulp with Be the Fiber, who do some recycling of cotton to make new cottons and then new products out of this cotton. And then, so you have all these entrepreneurs with who we constantly search also to make some programmation. So we have pop-up and frequent activities that come back. We also work in this together with other parties than the entrepreneurs that are present all the time. So here we have an example of a reading that we organized on some sustainable topic. We did, and here my English maybe is missing a little bit, but we also learned people to make their own their own yarn by spinning it themselves. Very nice, very popular workshop. We organize sustainable markets where whoever who wants can come and sell his products or services. And what else? We also use Circuit as a place where bigger brands can do tryouts. We are planning a tryout with Ecovair on the refill machines. We will organize with a certain brands the empty shop. This is an empty space where we ask them people to bring nice clothing that we sell for the good cause. With Centex Bell, we also are looking to work together with parties like Decathlon to see what Circuit can mean in repair maybe for them. IKEA, CKS, it's one big hotspot of sustainability and working together. And that was it, I think, for my presentation.
Frank, thank you. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
It's open. I don't see, of course, it was a bit late to announce it, but if I resume a little bit, actually, the initiative of Circuit is actually creating a high-end shopping experience by selling sustainable products, either with second-hand or homemade or locally made products. Is that how I could summarize the initiative?
Yeah, but it's broader than that. It's also about bringing services. So not only selling products, and around this creating site activities that makes it interesting to people to come there, to make it a whole experience. And this idea actually I took out of the event sector, where I also was active for quite some years, and where we saw that when people are in a situation where everything is fun, it's much more easy to come to behavioral change. And so we try to recreate this event experience, let's say, in a fixed location, where of course everything is sustainable, but in the end it's also these activities like workshops, readings. It could be also sometimes some music. For example, we work together with the famous guitarist of Deus, Mauro Pavlovsky, to do something around music. And all of this to in it should just be fun to come there and to consume. But as you do this, you make a better world.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's very nice. There's one question I see, whether you have a specific target audience. Do you focus on a particular group of people?
No, we try to keep it as large as possible. And that's one of the big, I did not explain it in the PowerPoint, but it's one of the big things in this area. It is, of course, an area with a lot of money, but there's also 10% of social apartments, because this is obligation. And of course, the public with which we work to bring this experience, these typical workers of Kringwinkel that we use also in Circuit, there is quite a distance between them and the public that typically lives in this area. And what we try also to do is build a bridge between these different communities, because sustainability, and that's what we tend to forget, of course, Tesla and this kind of things, it makes the world better, but it's not for everybody. And how can we create a circular experience, and how can we make sustainability something in which everybody can participate and take part?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Very interesting what is going on over there. So thank you very much for explaining us this initiative.